So healthcare costs now rising despite the promises of the Affordable Care Act. Prices only about to go higher as well. But you may not know it until November 15th. That's because my next guest says the government is keeping insurance companies from telling you about the spike that is coming in healthcare costs. Grant Bourne is the co-founder of Healthcare Solutions. He represents insurance companies all over the country. And good morning to you, sir, today there in Chicago.
Good morning, Bill. How are you?
I'm fine. We saw the story pop a few weeks ago. Is this true? Has the government told insurance companies not to talk about a rate increase?
You know, I don't know exactly what's going on with the mechanics behind the scenes. What I do know is that the open enrollment originally was supposed to start October 1st. They moved it out to November 15th. And so now we're a couple weeks out, and you know, we have yet to see the pricing on the new plans, which I find a little bit puzzling.
Okay, are they hiding something or not, Grant? What do you think?
You know, I don't know if they're hiding anything, but what I do know is that the you know, behind the scenes, what we're hearing is that rates are certainly going up. What we're seeing on renewal rates in some cases is double digits. For some small companies, we've actually seen some rate increases almost in the triple digits.
All right. So when you look at the law and what the president said, he said the rate of the increase will not be as great. Will it or not?
Well, here's what's happened is there's been significant cost increases. Back when the law was passed, a family could buy insurance for $500 a month, and now it's roughly $1,000 a month. So, you know, it's almost doubled. That's the bad news. The good news is that people are having access to a lot better coverage. You know, they were able to cover pre-existing conditions, for example. We can help clients we couldn't help before who used to get turned down. So there's a lot of benefits to that piece of the law. However, there's a gigantic cost increase associated with it.
I see. So there's some good and some bads. That's fair and balanced, right? I mean, you see some positives from this law. You also see some negatives. And the negative consistently is you're getting coverage for things that you don't need. Now, in your view, is that something Washington is willing to change, which may help keep the increase that you're talking about lower?
No doubt. And that's one of the biggest problems, right? The good thing is we can help people who need coverage who are sick. The bad thing is there are a lot of people who don't want to pay for what the government is trying to get them to pay for. Things like maternity, infertility, pediatric braces, stomach stapling, you know, unlimited mental illness, chemical dependency, things that some people may choose not to actually have and pay for. Now the government's saying, well, you need to have those benefits and you're required to pay for them.
Now,
unless you're lucky enough to get a subsidy.
Right, as you look, yeah, subsidies, that's another topic, okay, for another day. But as you look back on this law, why was all of that put into it? What's the rationale for that, Grant?
Well, the rationale was the government was trying to get everybody to do one thing, right? You're going to have four plans and you're going to go buy it through healthcare.gov, and they were going to kind of take over the system. But what people need to understand is you don't have to go to healthcare.gov. You don't have to buy from the government. As a matter of fact, if you go to an independent agent, for example, we have 500 agents nationally, they're all independent. You can go to an independent agent and we're impartial. So if you want to get a government plan, we can go in the back door of healthcare.gov. We can get you a subsidy within 20 minutes or so. But you don't have to go directly to healthcare.gov because those folks work for the government and they're only going to give you access to a government plan. So there are a lot of other options and solutions out there outside of what the government is trying to get you to believe that you have to do.
Okay, November 15th, the next day, we'll see what happens then. We'll see whether or not you're right. Grant Bourne, thank you.
The other point you want people to know
is that you're going to have to do this every year. That too is another topic for another time. Thanks, out of Chicago.
Absolutely. Hey, I appreciate you. Thanks.
You bet.